This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about price supply and price demand equations and equilibrium points. Here's the problem we're going to deal with. This says that at a price of $2.25 per bushel, the annual U.S. supply for corn is 8.2 million bushels, while the demand is 10.4 million bushels. At a price of $3.25 per bushel, the supply is 10.2 million bushels and the demand is 8.4 million bushels. Assuming that the price supply and price demand equations are linear, write an equation for each and find the equilibrium point. Okay, let's start out by taking all this information and putting it into a table. We're talking about three things. We're talking about the price, the supply, and the demand. And we're told that when the price is $2.25 per bushel, the supply is 8.2 million bushels, and the demand is 10.4 million bushels. And then when the price goes up to $3.25 per bushel, the supply also increases. The supply goes up to 10.2 million bushels, but the demand decreases to 8.4 million bushels. Okay, so that's all the information we were given. Then the problem says, assuming the price supply and price demand equations are linear, write an equation for each and find the equilibrium point. Okay, so we're basically writing two linear equations. The first one is the price supply equation, and then the other one's going to be the price demand equation. So we'll start with price supply. When we do a price supply equation, the input is the supply. That's our x column. And the price is the output. That would be a y column. So let's make a little table of values for just the supply and the price. When the supply is 8.2, that equates to a price of 2.25. And when the price is 10.2, that equates to a price of 3.25. We want to use this information to make a linear equation. So I'm going to find the slope of the equation first. I use the slope formula, m for slope equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. And I'll use the information I have here for my x's and y's. So I'm going to have 3.25 minus 2.25 and then 10.2 minus 8.2. 3.25 minus 2.25 is 1, and 10.2 minus 8.2 is 2. So the slope is 1/2, or as a decimal, 0.5. So let's start out with what we know about the price supply equation. That's going to be, let's write supply over here, y equals 0.5, that was our slope x, plus b. We have to find the b. So to find the b, I'm going to take a pair of values, I use the top line here, and plug them in for x and y. So the y is going to be 2.25, and that will equal 0.5 times the x, which is now 8.2, plus b. I'll have 2.25 equals 0.5 or 1/2 times 8.2, so that's 4.1 plus b. I'll subtract 4.1 from both sides, and I get negative 1.85 for b. So the supply, the price supply equation is going to be y equals 0.5x minus 1.85. 1-800-875-8585. Okay, now, let's do the same approach again and use the demand information for price demand function. So now in my X column, I want the demand information. When the price was 225, that equated to a demand of 10.4. And when the price was 325, that equated to a demand of 8.4. We'll make a linear equation out of this information. We'll find the slope. That's going to be 3.25 minus 2.25 over 8.4 minus 10.4. So 3.25 minus 2.25 equals 1. 8.4 minus 10.4 equals negative 2. So the slope is negative 1/2, or as a decimal, negative 0.5. So the demand function, the price demand function, is going to be y equals negative 0.5x plus b. We have to find the b for this. So I'll plug in 10.4 and 2.45 for my x and my y, 2.25. So I want 2.25 equals negative 0.5 times 10.4 plus b. I'll have 2.25 equals negative, then 1/2 of 10.4 is 5.2 plus b. I'll subtract 5.2. I'm sorry, I'll add 5.2 to both sides, and I get 7.45 for the B. So for the price demand, I've got Y equals negative 0.5X plus 7.45. Okay, that's the first part of the question. It asked us to find the price supply and price demand functions. Then we have to find the equilibrium point. So the equilibrium point would be the place where these two equations have the same values. If we want to use a graphing calculator, you could plug both of these equations in and find out where the lines intersect. Instead, what I'm going to do is use an algebraic approach, and I'll just solve this as a system of equations. So I'm going to rewrite each equation with the x's and the y's on the left side of the equation. For the first equation, I'll subtract 0.5x from both sides. So I'm going to get negative 0.5x plus y equals negative 1.85. And for the second equation, I'll add 0.5x to both sides. So I'll get a positive 0.5x plus y equals 7.45. And then if I add both of these equations together, the x's will cancel out. I'll get 2y equals, let's see what I have here, equals 5.60. I want to divide both sides of the equation by 2. That means I'll have y equals 2.80. So remember, y was the price. I could fill that price in on this table that I made at the beginning. And that would mean when the price is $2.80, we have an equilibrium, and both the supply and the demand amount should be the same. Let's find out what those amounts are. So all I'll do is take this 2.80 for y and plug it into one of the equations. I could say that 0.5x plus 2.80 equals 7.45. Then I want to subtract 2.80 from both sides of the equation. And I get 0.5x equals 4.65. If I multiply both sides of the equation by 2, I'll get x equals 9.3. Okay, so the X is 9.3, which means that the demand and the supply will both be 9.3 million bushels. Okay, so the equilibrium point happens when the price is $2.80 per bushel. At that point, the supply and the demand are both 9.3 million bushels. And that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.